We all know that vinegar has been used medicinally for thousands of years. Acetic acid, which is the active ingredient in vinegar, was believed to be so potent that even Hippocrates himself used it to heal wounds. In today's world, we have research showing that vinegar could have many health benefits, such as managing blood sugar levels and possibly even suppressing fat. So in this video, I wanted to showcase for you the three ways in which it could do that, and also show you how much vinegar to incorporate for results. So stay with me till the end. Also, real quick, before we get started, it would mean the world to me if you hit the like button down below for the YouTube algorithm, subscribe if you like this type of content, and let's get started. I wanted to find a study that was actually done on humans with a fair amount of volunteers. What I was able to stumble upon was this one here. Vinegar intake reduces body weight, body fat mass, and serum triglyceride levels in obese Japanese subjects. The study participants were separated into three groups based on similar weight, BMI, and waist measurement. This study used apple cider vinegar only because it's more tolerable. During the test trial, the volunteers drank 500 milliliter beverage containing 15 mls of vinegar, 30 mls, or 0 mls. The participants' food intake and exercise were strictly monitored and accurately recorded during the study as well. They concluded that at the end, body weight, BMI, and BFR in both the low and high dose groups significantly decreased from week 4 in a dose-dependent manner. In addition, waist circumference, waist hip ratio, and serum triglyceride values also fell from week 8, which is really fascinating to see. But you might be thinking, how on earth can it do that? Well, the report explains that the suppression of body fat mass by acetic acid is due to the inhibition of lipogenesis mediated by decreases in gene expression of fatty acid synthase, acetyl-CoA carboxylase, and malic enzyme, among other factors. So that's the first pathway. The second pathway actually gets a little bit more interesting. In the Journal of American College of Cardiology, a paper called Dietary Strategies for Improving Postprandial Glucose, Lipids, Inflammation, and Cardiovascular Health highlighted the second pathway. Its section on vinegar showed us that indeed, modern studies indicate that vinegar significantly reduces post-meal glycemia, probably because acetic acid slows gastric emptying and thus delays carbohydrate absorption and improves satiety. I actually have two videos that look at foods that play this exact same pathway, which I highly encourage you to watch after this one. It goes on to talk about how recent studies show that 1 or 2 tablespoons of vinegar when added to a meal containing high glycemic index foods, such as white bread or white rice, will both 1, lower postprandial glucose by 25% to 35% and increase post-meal satiety by more than 2-fold. The post-meal satiety is huge and I think very underestimated because you got two things out of it: lower cravings and lower calories. So let's count the potential pathways so far. 1, inhibiting lipogenesis by decreasing gene expression of certain enzymes from creating fatty acids in the body. Secondly, slowing gastric emptying and delaying carb absorption for satiety. But hold on, guys, I've saved the best for last, which I have a feeling you might like. In the Diabetes Journal, a paper called Vinegar Ingestion at Bedtime Moderates Waking Glucose Concentrations in Adults with Well-Controlled Type 2 Diabetes, it was concluded that the anti-glycemic effect of acetic acid, which is the active ingredient in vinegar, has been attributed to reduced starch digestion, which, guess what? We talked about and/or delayed gastric emptying. Again, we talked about neither of these proposed mechanisms likely explains the effects noted herein. Moreover, to our knowledge, this is the first report describing a hypoglycemic effect of vinegar apart from mealtime. Hence, acetic acid may possibly alter the glycolysis, gluconeogenic cycle in the liver, which may benefit diabetic individuals with metabolic disturbances, contributing to a pre-breakfast rise in fasting glucose, also known as the dawn phenomenon. And this is what 2 tablespoons of apple cider vinegar at bedtime. Speaking of the dawn phenomenon, in case you don't know, it's between 4 a.m. and 8 a.m. where there is an early spike in your blood sugar in diabetics, which is a little different than this Somogyi effect, which occurs due to a rebound effect from late night hypoglycemia. The only thing I wish about this study is the fact that it would have been nicer to have a bigger sample size. There weren't that many participants in the study as well, just
FYI.
If you want more depth on vinegar and BMI, then you can watch this video I made here. It goes into a little bit more depth on this. I also linked below some of my favorite apple cider vinegar gummies as just an affiliate if you want to support the channel. You can find them in the description below. But the big question is all vinegar the same? Does it really matter which one I start with? Depending on the acetic acid content, either 3% to 9% by volume, different types of vinegar will have a stronger taste. So taste a few to see which ones you like best. And the doses can range from a teaspoon to a tablespoon taken with a full glass of water up to 3 times per day. Most of the studies looked at 1 to 2 tablespoons though. Keep in mind, you can also mix it with olive oil and drizzle it on some salad greens to mask the taste. I will have to let you know on some of the drawbacks though. Not entirely a deal breaker, but ones to know are damaging the esophagus, which happens if you drink vinegar from the bottle, which you definitely don't want to do. It also can damage teeth enamel, which usually happens if you try to take a higher dose, and an upset stomach. Also, too much vinegar, depending on the person, can also lower your potassium levels. So if your potassium is already low or you are taking, let's say, a water pill, you want to discuss this with your doctor first before trying it out. But I'm more curious to hear from you guys though. What are your thoughts on apple cider vinegars? Let me know in the comments below. Also hit the subscribe button too if you found any value in this video, and I'll see you on the next one.